Hey, welcome back to Mr. Mig's Classroom. I'm Mr. Mig, and today I'm going to talk about the FAA Part 107 exam. So I've been doing a series about the drone exam. So if you want to be a commercial drone pilot, you have to pass this exam. And today what I'm going to talk about are those questions on the Part 107 exam that involve the direction of an aircraft. So there are a few questions on there that might ask you what direction an aircraft is heading in or where an aircraft is relative to the runway. An example of these questions might be something like, you're listening to CTAF and a pilot announces left midfield downwind runway 16. And then it might ask you, what direction is the aircraft heading in? I'm going to go over how you can determine what direction the aircraft's heading in, and then I'm going to talk about the aviation compasses as well as why the runways are set up the way they are. So let's go into that first. So let's start off with the aviation compass, and then I'm going to go into the runways and what like the runway numbers mean, because that helps a lot with these questions. So first thing here is I'll make a little compass. So I already have my compass here, and we'll just assume that's a circle. Sorry, I'm not the best drawer. So up here, how this works, instead of writing north, they write numbers. So right, this would be north on our compass, but they're just going to write the number 0. Over here, this would be east, but they're just going to write the number 9. So let me take, well, I'll leave north on there for you. Down here, they're going to write 18 instead of south. And then over here, they're going to write 27 on the aviation compass instead of west. So what this is that's they just add a 0, right? So that it's 90 degrees is east. 180 degrees is south. 270 degrees is west. But to save space, they drop the zeros, so instead of getting 90, 180, and 270, you just get 9, 18, and 27. All right, so those are just the directions. So now we get our runways. Our runways are just based off the compass directions. That's it. That's all they are. When you're flying on an airplane and you see that you're landing at runway 9, all that means is that you're on the runway that goes in the direction of east. That's what that means. So specifically, and this is where we get into headings here, when the plane is landing, the plane is going to be landing heading in the direction of 90 degrees or east. So whether this is taking off or landing, it's the same thing. So if we have a plane that's taking off on runway 9, it means the plane is moving and traveling east or in the direction of 90 degrees. So the plane's going this way, and it's taking off toward 90 degrees. If the plane's landing, same thing. The plane's circling around. The plane lands, moving in the direction of 90 degrees or east. If that plane was on that same exact runway, except the plane wasn't heading in 90 degrees, the plane was heading in 270 degrees or west, now we would call this runway 27, because the runway is always based on the direction the aircraft is heading in. So if the plane is heading this way, to the west, to 27 degrees, whether it's taking off or landing, we're now calling this runway 27. So how do we determine, or how does the FAA determine which way the plane's going to take off and land in? It's based on the wind. Planes like to take off and land into the wind because it helps with lift. So they like the wind facing them. They want a headwind when they're taking off and landing. So if the wind is coming out of the west, then we're going to take off heading into the west. Same if the wind is coming out of the east, then we're going to take off and land heading into the east. All right. I hope that makes sense. If that's confusing, just ask me and I'll re-go over that one. All right, so that should kind of help you with what the runways mean. They simply mean the direction the plane is traveling in. Okay, so now we have that. So now let's go to an example of one of these questions here, because I think these questions are tough. So here I wrote up, let's say the question is something like this. You're listening or you're monitoring CTAF at a local airport, is a drone pilot really going to do this very often? Probably not, but here's the reality, folks. Some people will ask me this. Well, you know, I'm not really going to fly at an airport as a drone pilot. I mean, maybe if you're inspecting it, or say you're working for the police department and you have to be near the airport for some reason, maybe you would. But The point is they ask you this on the test, right? This gets asked on the test, so you need to know this. So you're listening to CTAF, and pilot announces left downwind runway 16. What is the heading of the aircraft? So it's asking you what direction is the aircraft moving in. That's what it means by heading. So if the runway is 16, so let's go ahead and erase all this off here. So what's 16 mean? Well, 16 means it's going to be pretty close to south. It's probably going to be right about here. So 160 degrees is the direction. So we got a runway here, runway 16. Okay, so that's our direction that this aircraft is going to land in. That's why it's runway 16, because the aircraft is going to land at 160 degrees. So it's going to be landing in that direction. All right, so now we know the direction that the aircraft is landing in. Well, that tells us what direction the wind is probably blowing in, right? The wind is therefore coming out of the south or south-southeast, this would be, but it's coming out of 160 degrees. So it's the wind is blowing this way because we want to land facing into the wind. Remember, we want a headwind when we're landing and taking off. All right, good. That helps a lot too. We need to know that. So the wind is therefore coming out of the southeast. And let's write that down. Wind is south, southeast. That's what we'll write down. So we'll have that. All right. So we need that. That's actually kind of an important factor here when we're figuring out where the plane's at. Because when a plane is preparing to land, there's a procedure it kind of takes. So normally what happens is the plane is going to take it's going to come in at a 45 degree angle into our downwind leg. That's what downwind over here means. It's part of the landing procedure. So there's a downwind leg. So what's going to happen is the plane's going to come up this way. This is going to be the downwind leg, downwind, and then I'll write leg here so you have that. That's the downwind leg of the landing there. Then the plane's going to take a turn, right? And this is going to be the base leg. And then the plane's going to take another turn. And this is when they do their final approach, right? And that's when they're going to land here. So that's what the downwind leg means. So what's this left mean over here? Because this confuses a lot of people, this word left. And they're starting to think, well, does it mean the plane is over here? How do you know the plane's here and the plane's not over here? It's saying left. That's not what left's talking about in this situation. What left means is that the plane is going to take left-hand turns as the plane is landing. So typically when a plane's circling a runway, they're going to turn to the left. The plane's turned to the left. And they do this because like the pilot's sitting on the left-hand side of the aircraft, so it's easier to look out of that window there on the left, so the plane turns to the left as the plane lands. I said usually, I didn't say always. Sometimes it could be right. So if they say right downwind runway 16, that means that the airplane is going to turn to the right. Okay, that's really important to know here. That's why I put these turns as left turns. But normally, whenever I've seen on the practice questions, it's almost always left. Because usually the plane lands to the left. Now it's whatever the FAA designates for that airport. There could be exceptions, but usually it's to the left. All right. So the plane makes it's in its downwind leg. So the plane's probably over here somewhere. We'll let this circled X be the plane. I'm not a good drawer, so I'm not even going to try to draw the plane. So we'll let that circled X be the plane. This is the plane right here. Okay. The plane's on the downwind leg. It's going to make left turns. We know that because it says left. And then it's going to land facing this direction in 16 because it's going toward 16. So it's facing in 160 degrees. So if it's on its downwind leg and it's going to land at 160 degrees, this is actually a pretty easy question. It just means that the plane is going in the exact opposite direction right now in which it's going to land. It's going to land at 160 degrees. So right now it's traveling in exactly opposite of that. So we know 160 is where it's going to land at, 160 degrees. So what we can do to get the exact opposite of 160 is add 180. The reason I'm adding 180 is because there's 360 degrees in a circle. I put this as zero, but we could just easily call this, right, 360. We could all call that 360 right there, because there's 360 degrees in a circle. I won't, because I don't want to confuse things, so I'll take that off. So half of 360 is 180. If the runway is less than 180, then add 180. If it's the runway number is greater than 180, then subtract it. That'd be the easiest way to do it. In this case, I'm going to add 180 because it's runway 16. Whereas if it was runway 27, if it's greater than 180, I'm going to subtract it. Because if I add 180 to 270, then I'm going to get more than 360, and I don't really want that. All right. So I'm going to add 180 here. So I'll do that. So that gives us that gives us 340 degrees. That's it. That's the answer to this question here, right here. Left downwind runway 16, what is the heading of the aircraft? 340 degrees, because it's the exact opposite of 16 or 160. These questions really aren't that hard once you get used to them. At first, when my students were doing these questions, these were like crushers. These are like almost everybody was getting these wrong. But once you understand a few simple things here, I think the first simple thing you got to understand is that left here just means that's the direction that's the turns that the aircraft's making. The aircraft's making left-hand turns. Downwind is specifically talking about the leg, and that's always going to be the opposite in the direction that the aircraft's actually landing in. Once you understand those simple things, left and downwind, what they mean, and then what 16 means, that 160 degrees, you're good as gold. These are easy. All right, let's do one more, but let's change this a little bit, because sometimes what you'll see, instead of the heading is, or what is the heading of the aircraft, you might see something like, where is the aircraft in relation to the runway? You might see something like that. So like, where is the aircraft? I'll just put aircraft, okay? What am I doing? Aircraft. Okay, so where is the aircraft in relation to the runway? So let's say that's our question here. And in those questions, usually it'd be something, let's just do a different one here. I'll redraw our circle, because when you redo these, you should redraw your circle anyway. Kind of give you a little bit of practice with these. So I'm going to erase this one. Now let's do a different one. Let's do, you are monitoring the CTAF. You hear an aircraft announce that it is, sorry, I should be facing the camera, that it is midfield left downwind runway 36. Where would the aircraft be relative to the runway? So let's do this. Take this one off here. And we have, midfield left downwind runway 36. Sometimes they'll write it out like the number 3, the number 6, like I did in the last one. Sometimes they'll write 36. Okay. So where would the aircraft be relative to the runway? So where is the aircraft? All right, so let's go ahead and draw these out again and see where our aircraft is. So first, I'm going to start with my circle, okay? And I'll just put north on here so I have my north. And then we got, this one's pretty easy, right? If it's runway 36, that's also 0. That's north, right? So cool. So our runway is perfectly north and south. That's what that means, because 360 degrees is also 0 degrees. All right, cool. So got a kind of an easier one. I'm just going to put like the middle lines on the, I like to put those in. You know, the reason I like to put those in is because then I also like to kind of put an arrow. So this tells me that if it's runway 36, then the aircraft is going to land in this direction, in the 0 direction. 36 would be 0, right? There's 360 degrees in a circle. So, and if you want me to write that on here, I'll write that on here. Runway 36. Here, we can do that. to make it a little bit better. Okay, all right, so we got a north-south facing runway here. So let's go ahead and do our plane movements now. So we have our plane, it's gonna make left-hand turns. So it's gonna come in to the downwind leg, which is gonna be the opposite direction of the landing. So the landing's 360, so the aircraft's coming in the opposite direction. The downwind leg is this whole section right here. So you can think of it as, again, downwind leg, then crosswind leg, or sorry, base leg, this would be base leg. This would be downwind. And then crosswind is actually up here. Crosswind leg is going to be that direction. But when the plane's landing, it's coming in at a 45 degree angle into the downwind leg. All right, so if it's midfield, we'll say that the aircraft, therefore, is right about here. So we'll call this our aircraft. So we'll say it's facing in that direction. So it's in our downwind leg, midfield. So midfield's talking about the runway, so maybe I should have had it up just a little bit higher, but that's okay. And then it's going to make left turns, right? So the aircraft's coming in, and it's going to turn to the left, and then when it comes in for its approach, it's going to turn to the left again. Okay? So again, that's what that left turns means. Maybe I should have, you know, made this the other way so it's not confusing, because it looks like it's a right turn to us, but the aircraft's traveling this way, right? So it's making a left turn. So the aircraft's turning left. It's not so much your view, right? The aircraft's taking a left turn. Okay, so where is the aircraft in relative to the runway? This one's pretty easy now. Now that we know what downwind leg means, then we should be good. I mean, that's kind of the important part here. It's part of the downwind leg, and we know that it's traveling in that opposite direction of 3-6 because it's going to land in runway 3-6. So therefore, your answer choices are probably going to be something like, you know, this is west, down here south, you know, over here is east. So our answer choices are going to be something like maybe west, east, and south. Well, it's west of the runway, right? That's it. That's that one. That one's not too hard, right? So that would be those, where is the aircraft in relation to the runway? Sometimes when the runway spun a little bit, it could be in a situation where it's like northeast. But when I've seen those questions, usually it only gives you the opportunity to pick north or east on the answer choices. Anyway, I don't want to make this video too long. I'm trying to make the videos a little bit shorter. They've been running on a bit, but that's okay. Hey, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section. And make sure to go ahead and click that thumbs up button, because that does help with the algorithm. Leave any comments that you have. If you have any questions on any of this or you want me to post any other videos, please go ahead and put those down in the comment section, and I'll make those videos for y'all. But once again, hey, thank you for watching Mr. Mig's Classroom. I'll see you next time. Till then, click that like button. Take care.